Hey guys, thanks for joining. So in this video, we're gonna go over how to configure SSH proxy. Please like and subscribe, that would be really helpful. So in the previous video, we did perform SSL decryption forwarding. So in this video, we're gonna configure a SSH proxy, all right? So we already created a decryption profile. You have the default one. And for us, we created one called NetPrepare default decryption profile. You click here. We've already blocked, those are the recommendation by Paolo Alto. We did also for the do not encrypt, no decryption. And this is for the SSH proxy. All right, they recommend to block session with unsupported version, block session with unsupported algorithm. This is also good to have. Just the session we don't have any more resource available to do the decryption, like it means maybe we're under attack. It depends how strict you wanna be. I recommend having like both, maybe one for your internal resources that you know what the algorithm is, and one for, I don't know. It depends how strict you wanna be, okay? We'll go over the SSL inbound inspection. This is, we already went through it, but we'll go over this in the next video. All right, so now let's go under profile. For the SSH configuration proxy, just you don't need to create the SSH key or anything like that. The firewall will automatically create that. And you could see how this is happening. So the client is initiating the SSH session to the server. The firewall inspected. Then the firewall initiates the SSH session to the server and then replies. And then, so it's like the firewall is in the man in the middle, all right? And you could read more here on how it's working with more detail, okay? So let's specify SSH decryption. And we're gonna specify this SSH TCP 22. This is a service that we already created. An URL, decrypt, SSH proxy, and prepare default, okay? That's basically all you need to do with the SSH proxy. Alright guys, I think that's enough for this video. We'll go the next video, we're gonna go over how we're gonna do SSL inbound inspection, and how we have to add like the server certificate onto the firewall to be able to decrypt the traffic. Yeah, I'll go over it in the next video. Thank you for joining. Please like and subscribe, that would be really helpful.